Hello guys, welcome to my channel. This is Uday Pandit and you are watching MEP Technical World. In previous video, I have discussed about preventive maintenance of the diesel generator or DG set. In this video, we'll learn about sizing of diesel generator or how to select DG size. So let's start it. So we have some steps for sizing the diesel generator. So let's follow these steps. Step first, find the total connected load of the building or industry. And step 2, add 10% extra load to the final calculated total connected load for the future consideration. Step 3, calculate maximum demand load based upon the demand factor. And step 4, calculate maximum demand in KVA. Step 5, calculate generator capacity with 80% efficiency. And finally, step 6, select the DG sizes as per calculated value from the DG selection chart. So now let's discuss each steps one by one. So come to step 1. In step 1, we have to calculate the total connected load. Suppose we are going to calculate the total connected load of this hotel buildings. So we have some assumption load for this hotel buildings. So this building comes under the commercial building. So in this building we have total raw power load is 80 kilowatts and total lighting load is 100 kilowatt, including ceiling light, facade lights, landscape lights, as well as others, and plumbing loads, which is 110 kilowatt, including various pumps like filter pumps, hydropneumatic pumps, etc. And elevator load is 40 kilowatt, and DG auxiliary load is 30 kilowatt. So let's sum of these loads. So finally, total connected load TCL is addition of all these load is 333 kilowatt. So this is our total connected load of this hotel building. Now come to step 2. So in this step, we add 10% extra load to the final calculated total connected load for the future consideration. We add this load for future consideration. In future, might be load will be increased in various sector. That's why we have to add 10% extra load while calculating the DG size. So we have already calculated total connected load in previous step. So it was 333 kilowatt. Now calculate 10% extra load of this total connected load. So this is 10 into 333 kilowatt divided by 100, and it comes 33.3 kilowatts. Now we can say final total connected load TCL is 366.3 kilowatt. Now move to step 3. So in this step, we are going to calculate the maximum demand load based upon the demand factor. So demand factor of various fields or industries have difference. Like demand factor of the commercial building is 80%. If we talk about residential building, demand factor of that is 60%. And if you talk about industrial building, then demand factor of the industrial building is 90%. So according to that, we are calculating for hotel building. So this is under the commercial buildings. So we have taken demand factor is 80%. So why we have to calculate this demand, maximum demand load? Actually, in our hotel buildings or others buildings, for 24 hours, these all loads are not connected into the power supplies. It may be varies. In the daytimes, all lights are switched off. That's why this lighting load is not connected to the our system. And even in night, our some of the machines are also turned off. That's why we can say our all loads are not connected at 24 hours to these systems at a time. That's why we have to calculate maximum demand loads. If we calculate this maximum demand load of the buildings, it will help us to calculate the real size of the diesel generator. If we calculate the DG size according to the total connected load, so DG size will be also increased, hence cost will be also increased. That's why we have to calculate maximum demand load of the buildings. So let's calculate it. So we have already calculated final total connected load including 10% extra load, which is 366.3 kilowatts. Now calculate the maximum demand load as per the 80% demand factor. So according to this, 80 into 366.3 divided by 100. So final calculated maximum demand load is 293.04 kilowatt. So this maximum demand load is in kilowatts, which is in active power. Now let's come to step 4. In this step, we are going to calculate the maximum load in KVA, which is in apparent power. So let's convert this maximum demand load, which is in kilowatt. So let's calculate the maximum demand load in KVA, which is apparent power. So final calculated maximum demand load is 293.04 kilowatt, which is in active power. To convert it into KVA, we have to consider the power factor 0.8. Now let's calculate the maximum demand load in KVA. So 293.04 divided by 0.8, which is power factor. After calculation of this, it comes 366.3 KVA. So now our demand load is, maximum demand load is in KVA, which is 366.3 KVA. Now move to step 5. In this step, we are going to calculate the generator capacity with 80% efficiency. Generally, our diesel generator are operating at 80% efficiency. So let's calculate the size according to that. So final calculated maximum demand load is 366.3 kVA. Now calculate generator capacity with 80% efficiency. So 80 into 366.3 divided by 100. So calculated generator capacity is come to 293.04 kVA. Now move to another step, which is step 6. In this step, select the DG size as per calculated value, which is in previous step we have calculated. According to that value, select from the DG selection chart. So our calculated generator capacity is 293.04 kVA. So this is the DG selection chart. So these sizes are available in the market. So let's select the DG size from this DG selection chart as per our calculated generator capacity, which is 293.04, so which is near about 320 kVA. So according to this, 320 kVA diesel generator is satisfied. So finally, our proposed DG set size is 320 kVA. So in this way, we have calculated the diesel generator size. Hope you understand it. So thank you for watching this video. Hope you like this video. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe, and also hit the bell icon so you will get notification regarding my upcoming videos related to electrical, plumbing, HVAC, as well as AutoCAD drafting. So thank you very much. See you again in next video.